Welcome back. As the return to in-person classes nears, about 5,000 classrooms in Central Visayas still need repairs. Let's get details. We have on the line ABS-CBN correspondent Annie Perez. Annie, are you with us?
Nikki?
Annie, go ahead.
Yes, Nikki, that's right. Over 5,000 classrooms in Region 7 are yet to be repaired. That's according to Department of Education Regional Director Salustiano Jimenez. Most of these classrooms were damaged by Typhoon Odette as the super typhoon hit Central Visayas in December 2021. Now, this is the thrust of the region's Brigada Escuela, which was kicked off yesterday. They want to make known to the public the urgent need for repairs as face-to-face classes are set to resume by November. They are now doing a caravan going around schools and inviting stakeholders, such as the local government units, line agencies, and private companies, to commit in repairing the classrooms and attending to the other needs of the school. As of this week, according to Jimenez, there are already 1.4 million students that have already enrolled for this school year. This is 75% of the department's target in the region of over 2 million students. More than 3,000 schools have been given the go signal to conduct in-person classes by August and full face-to-face in November. Since space is limited, shifting of classes will be done until classrooms are repaired or added. The department also reiterated that they are not requiring booster shots for both students and teachers, although it is very much encouraged. And that's the latest here from Central Visayas, Annie Perez, ABS-CBN News.
Thanks, Annie. Over 2 weeks since the launch of government's vaccination drive, Pinas Lakas, the health department continues to fall short of its daily vaccination target. The campaign hoped to administer booster shots to 397,000 individuals per day. But so far, it has only immunized nearly 442,000 in total. DOH officer in charge, Maria Rosario Vergeres, says, because of this, the agency will put up vaccination sites in schools to encourage parents to get their kids vaccinated. In other news, the Philippine economy expands less than expected in the second quarter, but in a pace still in line with government's target. Warren de Guzman reports.
The Philippine economy grew 7.4% in the second quarter. This was slower than the first quarter's expansion of 8.2% and the 12.1% growth rate hit in the second quarter of 2021. Socio-Economic Planning Secretary Arsenio Balisacan says growth was slowed by the impact of elevated inflation. He highlighted its effect on manufacturing. Quote, the manufacturing sector's growth decelerated to 2.1% in the second quarter, down from 22.4% in the same quarter last year. The slowdown was due to the weaker growth in computers, electronic and optical products, chemical and chemical products, and food products. The slowdown may be due to inflationary pressures brought about by the Russia-Ukraine war, weakening global demand, and supply chain disruptions brought by lockdowns in China. National statistician Undersecretary Dennis Mapa added that the seasonally adjusted quarter-on-quarter growth rate for services declined by 0.4%. He also noted that the seasonally adjusted household final consumption expenditure for the second quarter was reduced to negative 0.7% from the first quarter of 2.1%, and so that contributed to the decline in the services sector. The second quarter GDP expansion was also lower than most private sector economists' expectations. However, Secretary Balisacan noted the growth rate is still the second highest in Asia, behind only Vietnam's 7.7% expansion, although certain major economies like Malaysia and Thailand have yet to report. Undersecretary Mapa also noted that after the first half, the Philippine economy has grown to a size larger than pre-pandemic levels. He said, quote, in the first half of 2022, the current GDP value was 10.32 trillion pesos, and this is higher compared to the first half of 2019 is 9.29 trillion. For constant prices, the first half of 2022, it was at 9.6 trillion compared to the first half of 2019 is 9.49 trillion. So both in current and constant prices, the size of the GDP is already higher than 2019. Balisacan adds the 6.5 to 7.5% full-year growth target for 2022 is quite attainable, as the Philippines will only need to grow by 5.3% in the second half to hit the low end of that goal. The main plan, the short-term plan of the economic team right now is to continue supporting growth through the full reopening of the economy this year, and that includes a return to 100% face-to-face classes that is expected to generate jobs in support sectors as well as in the education system.